again. So we had a van breakdown yesterday. We learned a few lessons, and today's video is about how to survive a van breakdown. So our video today is going to be made out of three parts. What really happened, what saved us, and what lessons we learned so we could pass them on to you. So what happened, Andy?
Well, got up in the morning, got ourselves ready and going, packed everything up, and I turned the ignition. Nothing happens except the clicking sound.
Well, that's nothing, because it's all about circumstances. We were just traveling in Canada from Ontario to British Columbia, and we ended up in Saskatchewan, just about 200 kilometers before Regina. We parked in a small town, and we thought everything was fine. In the morning, nothing was fine. And the problem was, it was the middle of winter, which is November, with the very early winter this time.
Yeah, it's apparently 1 month ahead of schedule.
Yeah. Cold front was coming, which was about minus 22 Celsius, and the long weekend was about to start. That was Saturday morning, and we couldn't start. Not only that, the town we were in had only 800 people, which means it was a problem to get anywhere. And the mechanic, the only mechanic that could take us potentially, was closing in and out.
Okay, so what really happened? So when nothing was turning on, we called CAA.
Yes. Well, that was the next step. So then, because I didn't want to just fiddle around, we called CAA. Usually they're people, they have at least a tow truck. They can take you to a shop. They usually have a destination in mind, or we can pick something out ourselves. So we did, and the fellow came by within about a half an hour.
Okay.
And he put his booster on there.
Nothing.
Still the same thing. I didn't think, because the battery seemed to be full based on my meter. And then he brought out his hammer.
A hammer.
And while I was trying to start, he gave it a little ding with the hammer. And it immediately tumbled over.
He didn't wonk Andy's head. He wonk something under the hood. I don't know. I was inside. So yes. It was just, I hear a bang, and he says, start the car. And
yeah, and it tumbled right over. So now I'm not an expert on starters necessarily. He suggested that it is maybe the winding that was sticking, because the brushes are wearing out or something to that extent. I'm actually wondering, it was very mild overnight. It was only above freezing. And then it went down
suddenly.
Drastically. In the morning, suddenly you could feel it, the chill coming through inside the vehicle. We had to crank up the heating a little bit more. And I wonder if there's some condensation issue, freezing, and maybe it just got stuck up, frozen together, and him whacking it just freed that up, and it could tumble over again.
But the end is that we started and we managed to move to another destination. Yeah. Now we're still worrying that we might not start another time,
right.
But you know, and this is the 3 days that we have to wait until the mechanic, but we are sticking around in the larger city, at least where the mechanics are available.
Right, and that's a worry for future Andy.
So there are a few things that we've done that saved us. First?
Well, we have a CAA membership for just that purpose. Our vehicle, although custom built, is registered as a motorhome, so we have their motorhome plan. CAA does not have any commercial vehicle plans. And that is something important to consider when you're in a vehicle like this.
You also mentioned something about Sam's Club, and the Sam's Club doesn't have Canadian coverage, right?
Yeah, and we have a CAA card simply because it is also good for AAA in the United States, so there's an international coverage with it. In the States, there's a number of different options, like Good Sam's, and I think there are a few more, and they have all their ups and downs and whatever, but none of them seem to transfer into Canada. So we have CAA, and
yeah,
That'll work with AAA.
So our CAA plan is good for Canada and good for USA, mm-hmm. But Sam's Club is only good for USA, not for Canada.
That's right.
Just in case you're traveling internationally.
Right.
Another thing that saved us, besides having a CAA membership, was the backup system, backup heat, right?
Mitts and hats.
Mitts and hats and a few other things.
Blankets.
That, yeah, about heating systems we talked about in another video, which you can actually click through on the top. And in the minus 22 degrees, it's really hard to keep warm in the van, especially when you're in the middle of nowhere and the wind is howling around.
Right. Next thing we always make sure of, especially in climate situations like that, is that we are topped up with the fuel, both for the engine driving as well as our diesel heating system. And we also keep all supplies stocked up for a couple of days so that we don't have to worry about not eating or drinking.
It just happened that this 800 inhabitant town had only one grocery store, mom and pop, that was closing in a few hours, and it was not opening for next 3 days because it was a long weekend. It was Remembrance Day on Monday, and we were Saturday morning. So if we didn't have supplies, we would have been toast.
Right. And it's unfortunately reminiscent of last year when we went for our second journey in the van. We are traveling through Texas. We get to El Paso. We park for the night. It was Christmas Eve. And the transmission cooler breaks down for the third time. Wow,
yeah.
I mean, that was actually even more stressful than this time
it
around.
It was because the coolant you need for going up and down the hills, and El Paso is extremely hilly, which means we would, if we didn't, we wouldn't be able to repair it. We are done until probably January, standing right there, not even being able to buy food, groceries, water, nothing.
Yes. So, believe in Murphy's Law, what is it?
Whatever can happen will happen, and in the worst circumstances.
So for us, it seems to be the holiday hunt. Some people go for Halloween. For us, it seems to have, we have van breakdowns just before holidays. So we'll be watching out for that the next time before Christmas. Okay. So we've learned a few lessons from this, and we are still in the process of fixing the issue, but hopefully we'll emerge successfully as we did in the past, and we've learned a few tips that we want to pass on you. So what are the tips? First, keep a cool head and definitely have a CAA or AAA or Sam's Club, some backup. Otherwise you're paying yin yang for who knows how much money for the towing and the service. Second, internet. Make sure you have good internet connection. If we didn't, we wouldn't be even able to call
or
find
least,
them
at, or at least the cell phone.
Or at least find the grocery store that is close by. Whatever. At least the cell phone. Keep cash on hand just in case something happens. Again, if there's a fraud on your credit card, somebody has a broken machine, they don't take your credit card because it was declined for whatever reason, have at least $100 with you.
Okay? Murphy's Law.
Murphy's Law. Make sure you have at least 1 or 2 days supply of food and water, and mind long weekends, holidays, and closures do happen all the time. Mm-hmm. Make sure you always have a good weather app and watch it all the time. Is it rain, snow, freezing rain? Is it going to be a sudden drop of temperature, tornado? You need to know that, or else you're going to be in trouble. Okay, make sure you have everything topped up in the van perfectly, so in case one system fails, at least the second one is still working. Make sure you have always backup heat system or mitts and hats, or if you're in a hot climate, that you have at least shade available to you. There's also a consideration of the solar. If you are relying on solar like we do, cloudy days won't charge our batteries, so make sure you know how many days you can afford to go without sunlight.
Right. And for me, while I am moving about, I don't ever know what the weather will completely hold, how cloudy or sunny it is, in order to charge. When I have the opportunity and we are driving and it doesn't look like it's going to be charging too well, I always turn on the alternator mm-hmm. system that I keep topped up that way, especially in the colder winter climates up north here.
Yeah, and don't slack off. Keep your vehicle in top shape so it just doesn't happen. Don't leave everything to the last moment. I know it's a very tempting. Procrastination is a vice that we all have, but don't do it just in case, because if it's about to happen. Everything will fail all at the same time. And the final remark, always carry a hammer. Until next time.